Welcome to the Vector Garden YouTube channel. In this video, we're going to take a look at the retype function in Adobe Illustrator 2024. In this file, I have prepared some images. So these are pixel images that I have created. And this is a photo of a packaging. So this type is a little distorted. We all know that it's lobster, but let's see if Illustrator knows that as well. And these are my own fonts used in these files, but they are installed on the machine. So let's see what Illustrator does. This one is an Adobe font and it's uninstalled. And these are both Big Ham Pro. And I have used some, well, maybe more than some open type features on the top one. So let's see what it does. Now to enter it, you select the artwork. So either a pixel image or an outline font, and then you go to type Retype Beta. You can also open the window from the window menu. So down there is Retype Beta. But let's go in here and open it and start the thing. And you see, it recognizes some text in here. And actually, even on this photo that is inside that image, and it sees all that text and creates several dotted lines around them. So that's maybe because they are all different fonts or they are recognized at different individual words. And now we can click on them and see the fonts that Illustrator recognizes in there. And if you think they are not matching, then you can find some more. And these are 10 and they are ordered in the order in which they match best. So of course, these are Myriad Pro because I just didn't go far in order to create these. But Illustrator finds some similar ones that look quite like Myriad in case you want to have something special. Then we can just use that. Click on the one we want to have, which is this one here. We can double click that text here as the pop-up shows. So let's double click it. And you see, then Illustrator wants to download something and let's do it. So it needs to download some additional parts to this and let's just watch it do that. Once the download has finished, the retype feature is ready to use. And now we can actually double click that. And it's applying the font and it has now converted this to live text. So we can now exit this and then we can actually edit that. But also we should be able to select another one of these and again find the matching font. So let's go with another Myriad one and apply that. And again, it has been converted to live text. So let's go in here and do that as well. So let's see which one matches here. I'm going to take this one and apply that as well. And now we can actually see what Illustrator makes of it. So let's exit that. And then you see, we can edit this text and we can edit this text and this one as well. And just to check this out, I'm going to move this to the side and you see Illustrator has even edited that photo and hidden that previous pixel text. So let's undo that and you see, and in here, well, that's not quite as well because that should be black below there, but yeah, that has happened like this. Let's check out the other ones. So let's see what it can do with this. And now that the panel is open, let's go in here and enter that. And you see text recognition failed. So this just didn't work out because maybe because it's distorted. So let's see what it does with this one and enter this. And you see there it is. And it has recognized these three, but not this one down there. I have used the text as a clipping mask in there, and maybe that's just too much. So let's see what it has found. And there is Alfan, which is the correct one in this case. And let's just apply that. And yeah, we're going to embed it. And then let's enter it again. And let's get Alpha on here and apply that like so, and go in here and select these, and then let's check out Alpha and apply it. And we can go in here and then let's apply that here, and let's do it with this one as well. And then apply that. And again, the next thing is we can exit here and see what Illustrator did. And again, it has made some errors with retouching that. So let's check out this one. Let's enter it. And you see, this is actually my font. So I have made it, I have installed it, and there it is. But Illustrator doesn't recognize that ligature very well, but the other text it can do. So that's what we can make of that. So let's select it and apply it. And again, we have to first embed it, and then let's enter here and apply that. Let's check out another one of these. And since Illustrator didn't recognize the ligatures very well, so in here you can see what Illustrator recognizes, and you can edit that. So we can edit that here, and we could also apply that correct text. I'm going to just type those letters. And you see they get replaced here, and then we can apply that here, like so. Let's exit this, and let's go to this one and enter it. And there you see Illustrator can't deal very well with all these swash characters. But it recognizes the BigHem script. So in this word here, there we have it. And you see it recognizes it, but it doesn't apply the correct formatting here. So all these swashes, I would have to replace that. So let's apply this. And let's go in here. And you see Illustrator didn't even connect these words. So let's exit and let's check out this one, enter, and then apply this, and let's exit. And you see this didn't go very well, so this is the wrong character, but we can edit it and it's okay. Again, this here is my own font, so let's check it out. That, well, maybe that is just too much of geometry. Illustrator didn't recognize that as text at all. Let's check out this one. And it recognized something, but it can't find the font. The font is installed as well, but Illustrator can find that is a color font. So that's how the feature works, and now you can go ahead and use it. Have fun with it.